Sometimes things are right in front of you and you need somebody to tell you, why don't you just do this before you find out how to do it. Instead of hooking up the monitor, I got the display on my tablet from my Raspberry Pi for my DCC. I got Panel Pro up there right now. Let me show you how I did it. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And sometimes when you get comments, those people that are commenting give you help or give me help. And that's how I got to do this right here, hooking up this tablet to display what's on the Raspberry Pi. This is all that's needed. You need your DCC++, you got your USB cable going over to the Raspberry Pi, and the only thing hooking up to the Raspberry Pi is the power right here. So USB and power, and here's your display right here. And I'm going to show you how to do it right now. No mouse, no keyboard, no HDMI cable on it, just the power on there. You have to have everything hooked up first on your Raspberry Pi, your keyboard, your mouse, and your monitor, so you could activate it, get everything set up. Once you have everything set up, then you need nothing on there, and you have it on here. And I'm going to set it up on my computer. I'm going to show you how to do it on the computer. I had a comment on my video when I was hooking up the DCC++ to the Raspberry Pi, which I have right here, and JMRI. In their comment, they were talking about that they just purchased the 7-inch monitor, touchscreen monitor, that is built for the Raspberry Pi. And I said, well, that's a little bit too small for my eyes. I'm comfortable with my 10-inch tablet. He says, well, just hook up your tablet. I've been using the tablet for my throttle, but I could always put the throttle on one of my old cell phones. I looked into it. There's a program that's built into the Raspberry Pi. All you have to do is activate it. You don't see it when you first have it on there, but it's there. And I'll show you how to activate it on here, and I'll show you how to get it on your computer or on your tablet. I have the VNC open on my computer, and so what you're seeing up on the screen right now is on my computer monitor. So we're just going to go over to the configuration, preferences, Raspberry Pi configuration, and go to interfaces. Now you can see right here VNC is enabled. That's because I'm already using it. But when you first install the Raspbian on your Raspberry Pi, everything's going to show disabled on here. The reason that VNC is enabled is because I'm using it right now. Also, the serial console is enabled. That allows me to use DCC++ on it. So that's all you have to do is go into the preferences, go over to VNC and click on enable. Close this out and then restart, and it'll show up on the top. When you first install the operating system on Raspberry Pi, you won't see this up here, but once you enable it, you'll have this up there and you'll be able to pull this screen up right here. And basically this is your security screen. Whenever you first try to install a new computer that views your Raspberry Pi, this is the information that's going to come up on there, so you could verify that you're on the right device. This has Wi-Fi on it. Right now I'm running everything on my home router, but like I showed you in one of the other videos that I did, setting up your cell phone as a throttle, I used a router that I picked up at a thrift store. But I'm going to show you how to do it with my home network, and it's just as easy with the router. You just put in your IP address and you're all set on that. So let's look at the website. We got Real VNC. That's where you want to go. Let's see if I can find how I got there. It's a little... Okay, they have a professional and enterprise. We don't have to worry about there. Compare subscription in detail. Okay, here's where you want to go. All right. You want to look at the... this one up here, home. Convenient and easy to use for friends and family. Device access. Limited to 5 remote computers and 3 users. Okay. That's not the part that I'm really concerned about. You come down here on available things on here. Please note that a home subscription entitles you to extra features when used in conjunction with Raspberry Pi. So we'll click on the extra features or how to activate it on your Raspberry Pi. Since I already activated my account, all I have to do is sign in. But what you'll do is create an account and a password in there so you can hook it up to your Raspberry Pi. All right, we'll come up here and we'll activate. Activate a home subscription. I already create a VNC account and activate home. I guess all I have to do is sign in here. Okay. Okay, email address. There's my email address. I'm not a robot. Tom's Team Home. Okay, that's what I want. So what I want to do is I want to install it on this computer. Okay, get Vnc Viewer for devices you want to control from. I want to control my Raspberry Pi from this computer right here. You can get the app for an iPhone or an Android. But I'm going to get Vnc Viewer for this one here. I'm on Windows. Download Vnc Viewer. Okay, Vnc Viewer, save. I got it there. It's finished. Doesn't take very long. We're going to run here in English. Stuff is coming. This will install Vnc Viewer 618907. Boom. I accept. Next. Desktop shortcut. Yeah, I want one of them. Go to next. Install. And it's finished. I'm going to turn on the Raspberry Pi. Plug this back in right here. All right, turn this on. I'm starting this up from my computer so you can see the screen on the actual Raspberry Pi. So we can go through the steps of setting up the program, which is already installed on mine, but I'll just go through the steps for you. We have to put in the password. All right, there you go. We'll minimize that part and we'll bring this up right here. First thing we want to do is go back into our web browser and pull up the Real VNC and bring up the instructions. Now these two commands right here are for on your terminal. If you had your operating system on your Pi for a while, you want to make sure that you're up to date with your operating system and the Real VNC server. So if you just put the operating system on your Pi, you don't have to worry about these commands. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to copy this and bring up the terminal and then put this in the terminal. And it's checking to see if you have the latest update. If you have it, it's not going to do anything. If you don't have one, it's going to update it. And it looks like on here it updated. I only put this on there a few days ago. All right. It's still working on there. Okay, now it's finished. And then we'll highlight this second one here. And this one is for the real VNC server. And we'll do that. And it is already the newest version, so we're good to go with the VNC server on here. And like I showed you earlier, we already how to enable this right here. So we're good to go with that. And that's all these instructions do right here. Configure, that's what I already showed you. We're only concerned about direct connect on here. And that's what we've already done. We're not going to worry about the cloud connection on here because that's beyond the scope of this demonstration right here. What I did was change the screen resolution so it's different on here. I had it set originally for the monitor when I had the monitor hooked up directly through the HDMI cable to the Pi. Now that I'm running it remotely, I had to change the resolution so I could see all of the menus. When I pulled this up before, I was not able to see the top of the dialog box. On authentication via VNC password, this is what I have it set for. That's why I have to set a password whenever I access it. Usually on this, I'm going to go through these, and usually you just keep them as the defaults. Whenever you first do this and set this as VNC password, it's going to ask you for the password. And since I already have the password in there, it's not going to come up. But just know that whenever you change this to VNC password or change this, I turned this prefer off so I don't have to put my username in there, just the password. So it's going to pop up, select a password for your Pi or for your connection. And let me show you how to change the resolution on here. Right here, resolution. This originally was 720. Now I have it set for 1920 1080, which is what that monitor is. Now I could probably change it a little bit in between the two, because it shows up pretty small on here. But that's where you go to change to anything on the Raspberry Pi that you need to change on here. Now this screen here is 1280 by 720, which is a little bit better than the other one. It shows up a little bit bigger. So you have to play around with it, and the menus show up all right on here. I already tested them out. Let's pull up JMRI website, and that's a pretty good picture right there. I mean, you can play around with the resolutions on there to match your device. Okay, I'm gonna bring up my tablet here, and I have my VNC right there. Let's pull that up, turn this sideways. And it shows up pretty good on there. Okay, so it does work pretty good with the resolution change. It does adjust it for the different sizes. Let me see if I could. Okay, so where's my mouse on here? Right there. Okay. And you can't see the screen. Okay. Never mind. But it does work. It does show you a good picture on there. It's as easy as that to connect up a monitor to it. And you don't need anything but your power cable on there. Although I don't have my DCC++ on it right now, With that, all I would have had to do was hook up one USB cable from the command station. The command station right here. This USB cable connects the two of them, and you're good to go with your DCC++ and JMRI. So, until the next time, we'll see you.